not because patients are shy to tell. In our clinic, we are having the junior doctors which take history, so they tell them, but they can't tell us in the chambers. So we have given a pro questions that whether you have this problem or not, if the patient is long standing diabetic. I think so there is some problem.
Are you able to load the presentation?
Can you hear me?
Yeah, we
can. I think let's do one thing. You can continue sharing. If you can't do it, you can take the oral lecture. Once the technical issue is cleared, you can start sharing, but you can start with your talk.
It's showing your screen sharing is paused.
So you have to answer and share again.
No, I have stopped sharing, but it is not happening.
As far as I see, you haven't said it.
You try to share it again.
Yes. Option is coming only. Your sharing is paused or stop share. Two options are coming.
So you stop sharing first.
And
then again, click on the share screen button. First stop and then again click on the share screen button.
But stop sharing is also it is freezed.
Anyway, you can just start.
Okay, I think
that would be better.
Ashwin, sir, if you allow, I think we continue with the oral presentation because time is clicking.
Correct. Go ahead.
Fine. Sir, please go ahead. That's fine.
1 minute.
So sometimes some things, it is not in our hands. So this is one thing we have to totally rely on the internet.
Yeah.
Technology is like a kid, actually.
Yeah.
Times refuse to do anything.
Ashish Ekbar,
diabetes and sexual dysfunction, we know that it is a common problem, but undiscussed a lot in our clinics. So, first of all, I will let you know that diabetes lead to disruption of normal sexual function in both men and women.
It's completely disconnected now.
I told you, now technology is like kid. The kid has taken him out of anything.
Yeah, at the very moment when you record it the most.
I also don't see him in the participants list.
It might happen that he might be rejoining.
That is the best way, actually.
He will rejoin with all dysfunction.
So anyway, yeah, but very rightly said by him that sexual dysfunction generally we ignore, and patients also, they just like to keep it for their, you know, it's because of something which is very personal. So this is one very important area. We feel that we should be very practical, open-minded, and since this sexual dysfunction is directly linked to the cardiovascular disease, very important to address. Over to you, doctor.
Actually, sir, I am glad that this topic is there, because this should be talked much often. These things, actually, these are much neglected things, actually. And we seldom ask any of, we don't have the, even I should admit that we don't have the courage to ask our patient that whether he is having any sexual dysfunction or he is suffering from any sexual issues or something like that. Even in our clinic, we take a written yes, no sort of questionnaire, but we
Bharat, I presented it in a state conference 2 years back. After that only, I gained so much confidence in this subject. Initially, I was hesitant to ask in front of my lady staff. Now, my lady staff also knows when she has to go out. You need to probe patient, actually. And Ashish, every patient,
hello.
Yeah. Ashish, please.
Yes, Ashish, sir. You can.
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Please try to share again.
One.
In fact, I also asked to not only diabetic patient, to all the patients, whether they are on antihypertensive dyslipidemia treatment or they are a diabetes or any chronic crippling disease. This is one thing we have to discuss and we have to address this issue, because that psychosocial stress is a risk factor for all cardiovascular continuum. So this is I'm very happy that Dr. Bansi Sabu and the entire team took up this very neglected topic in our day-to-day care.
But once you start probing your patient, the patient will come to you seriously. The patient with sugar will not come to you, but patient with ED will come to you. If you start probing and start asking, because this is such a sensitive topic, nobody bothers. I have seen one patient who was suffering from priapism. Nobody has seen that genitalia, and everybody was giving that kind of.
Yeah. Oh my.
So,
in our clinic that we started in Ahmedabad 2 years back, me and Dr. Dhruvi, we have made a protocol that every male and female will be asked this question.
Yes.
And with our surprise, more than 50% patient having some or other trouble.
Yes.
Yes, Ashish sir is back.
Yeah. Just give a second. It is getting...
Even I have seen the center.
Ashish, you can talk on technical dysfunction also.
But yeah, this topic is coinciding with the 2nd October. So that is where I think Ashish is facing some challenges. So we have seen this,
your laptop needs a sildenafil.
डिजिटल ईडी हो गया उसको. राका का वर्ड है डिजिटल ईडी.
राका सर का दिमाग उधर ज्यादा घूम जाता है.
सो वी विल नॉट वेस्ट टाइम एंड आई विल गिव द एक्सटेम्पोरनो प्रॉब्लम. So diabetes and sexual dysfunction, we all know it is a common problem, and it is mostly psychological problem and pathological problem in diabetic population. But we don't take proper history, and that's why we ignore it. As sir was saying, that he priapism tha, and then we were going on to give him sildenafil, and he will face a lot of problem. So the presence of sexual dysfunction is seen both in type 1 diabetes also and type 2. There is a strong association between diabetes and erectile dysfunction in men. And what are the types of sexual dysfunction we see? Basically, most common is erectile dysfunction, but the desire, the decreased desire, the dyspareunia part, all these are neglected. So more severe and refractive ED in diabetic men is, they requires a lot of attention. So prevalence, we know that 35 to 75% of men with diabetes will experience some degree of erectile dysfunction during their course of diabetes days. But in our clinical practice, we have seen that patient ko 3 days back sugar hua hai and he is now ED. He is having ED. Psychological ED. They come to our clinic. Sir, mere ko sugar ho gaya. Maine paper mein padha tha ki isse erectile dysfunction ho jata hai. To mere ko ab sex karne mein problem ho raha hai. So this is a psychological where we need a counseling, where we need to give time to the patient. Then only he can have a good sexual life. And we should give him time because he is just a 3 days old diabetic. So the prevalence of erectile dysfunction in diabetes overall is 52.5 after adjusting for publication bias. And other problems like diminished sexual desire, lack of ejaculation with sexual climax and premature ejaculation, all these are also have to be taken care. And the ED is in diabetes is multifactorial. It will be due to the either vascular problem, hormonal problem, or neurological insults. We know that neuropathy in diabetes may impair autonomic and somatic nerve processes essential for erections. So the men with diabetes are at increased risk of low serum testosterone levels. Also, we have seen in the clinical practice when we do the serum testosterone levels, they have less testosterone levels in their reports. And how you will follow the male and female patients, what is the pathophysiological problems, you have to take care of the endothelial dysfunction, neuropathic pathway, you have to take care of the, like Raka was saying, that autonomic neuropathy, definitely it is a part which is causing the sexual dysfunction, the smooth muscle dysfunction, the arterial diseases, all these together causes sexual dysfunction in males. And the sexual female dysfunctions, they are also due to the psychological problems, mainly commonly seen, and vascular impairment, neuropathy are again a second part. And the taboo, that is social taboo, is a very important part in this field of sexual dysfunction. The diagnosis of sexual erectile dysfunction is very easy. You have to take the sexual history, whether he is having erectile insufficiency, whether the libido is less, ejaculation problem, orgasms, or partner sexual function problems are there. Medical history, that is the drugs what he is taking, whether he is taking beta blockers, atenolol, or hydrochlorothiazides, all these can cause erectile dysfunction. So efficacy of anti-diabetic interventions, the past histories of surgeries has to be taken, and the depression or any other psychiatric illness he is facing. So the screening is very important for erectile dysfunction. We have to take proper history. We have to do the serum testosterone levels, SHBG, that is sex hormone binding globulin, and albumin should be tested. And the symptoms of hypogonadism, in the morning hours, you have to take the history and check the testosterone levels. If they are less than 320 nanogram per deciliter, and free testosterone, if it is less than 64 picogram, then it is hypotestosteronism. The treatment is important in man because the man can survive earthquakes, epidemics, the horror of disease, and the agonies of the soul. But all the time, his most tormenting tragedy has been seen is always will be the tragedy of the bedroom. So he can't face the tragedy of the bedroom. So it is very important the patient should be treated properly, because I have one patient, she was scolding on me, doctor saab kya kar diya aapne, kya ilaaj de rahe ho mere ko aur pati ko bhai behan bana ke rakh diya aapne. Maine kaha hai maine kya kar diya bhai, to bole hamara 2 saal se sambandh nahi hua, aapne bhai behan bana ke rakh diya humko. Maine kaha bhai I am not the culprit, you are coming for the second time to me with sugars, first time they came with 500 sugars and they are blaming me ki main aapne humko bhai behan bana diya. So the treatment of ED is very important. The PD-5 inhibitor, we know that sildenafil and now the evenafil, which is the latest one, tadalafil, are also available, and they causes the vasodilatation of the erectile tissue of the penis. And commonly used agents for the local application are pepavirine, phentolamine, which are injected, and PG-1 has received formal FDA approval for management of ED. What are the advantages of PD-5 inhibitors? We know that it causes good erection and influence on the main etiological factor, but the potential side effects can be they are contraindicated in males taking nitrates, and the effective dose is different from general male population. Different patients require different dosages, and the efficacy in patients with severe diabetic complications is not proven. And the other options which are available, the intraurethral route, that is prostaglandin, vacuum erection devices, the prosthetic surgery, and the now the low intensity shock wave therapy is also available. The neglected part, that is the second part, is the female sexual dysfunction. I will tell you in nutshell that they can have hypoactive sexual disorder, they can have persistent genital arousal disorder, unwanted and intrusive feeling of genital arousal, which is very common in our patients, female orgasm disorder, that is very common. The female sexual arousal disorder can be seen commonly in our clinical practice. So this, we don't take history from the female patients because we are also afraid, and the females are also not so easy to tell all these things. But we should keep a female paramedical staff who can take this history. The type 1 and female sexual dysfunction is, again, they have the very high risk of female sexual dysfunction because of the neuropathy, vasculopathy in type 1 diabetics also. So in a nutshell, the management of sexual dysfunction is very easy. You have to take proper history. You have to change their lifestyle modification, do their weight loss therapies, put them on good diet, and stop smoking is very important. Alcohol consumption should be cut down. Take proper sleep. Psychological stress should come down, and the diet should be proper. So basically, counseling can treat near about 60 to 70% of ED patients or sexual dysfunction patient in our clinical practice, because most of the patients are psychological, and the long run diabetic patient can have the pathological erectile dysfunction also. So you have to first of all diagnose in which category this patient is falling, and then you can treat them properly and take the proper history of the hormonal problems also. You have to examine properly the genitalia, as Raka was saying, that you have to examine the genitalia also to have the what problem he is having. So with this, I finish this talk on sexual dysfunction and diabetes. Thanks a lot to the dignitaries, and thanks a lot, and sorry for the technical erectile dysfunction.